She was the first female late-night talk show host on a major network, winning 43 Emmy Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, Catherine Newberry.
Catherine, do you think women are funny?
Funny is funny.
As long as you're white, male, and from an elite college, like your writing staff.
We need to hire a woman.
Would a gay guy work?
No.
So you have no experience in comedy?
I'm obsessed with comedy. I do a little stand-up.
Where?
If you have a problem, ask the chemist. She'll always have the solution.
You're hired. If it doesn't work out, which you probably won't, you'll be gone.
Are you okay?
I'm so happy. I feel sick.
I came to tell you this year is your last.
What?
Who are you?
I'm a new writer.
The new female writer.
Yeah, I can see that, Brad.
Think about why the show is bad.
She's coming back! Don't push me.
And come up with ways to fix it.
The headline of my analysis is complacency.
I'll tell you what doesn't work. A newcomer coming in and giving me her assessment of my comic persona.
I will not be marginalized because no one here looks like me.
She's not trying to silence your strong female woman of color spirit. Hashtag me too, blah, blah, blah. You're a new writer with no experience. Write something.
Okay. The show hasn't been good for years.
Why didn't you say something?
I thought you knew and didn't care. You keep on asking
me the same question. I have some jokes for the monologue.
Tom Cruise is the same age as me. He gets to fight the mummy. I am the mummy.
I need you, Ollie, to help me change this show.
No more tantrums and no withering looks. Like that one.
That's my face. It's like I'm powerful. What exactly is wrong with my bits?
You're a little old and a little white.
What can I do about that? Let me introduce you to a new series, Catherine Newberry, White Savior.
I feel like I could never hail a cab.
Let's see what we can do about that.
I actually didn't need to go anywhere.
That doesn't matter. This is how white saviors work. Into the cab.
How would you describe Molly?
Molly is...
She said that I reminded her of a younger her.
Me.
I mean...
Shh.
Molly, over here.
I've spread my dreams under your feet. Tread softly because you tread on my dreams.
What?
I'm in a single-income household, and Jen and I just had our second baby. I think it's time for a raise.
I can't give you a raise, Gabe. It's like giving a raise to a drug addict.
My child's like a drug problem.
You're fired. You're fired, obviously.
Oh, you must be McCreary.
Oh, wow.
You're fired.
She's coming back! She's coming back. She's coming back!
Don't push me.
Who are you?
I'm Molly. Mm-hmm. I'm a new writer.
You want to sit down?
Okay.
That's where Mendelssohn sits.
Could you sit down, please?
Oh, I'll just use this trash can. There's hardly any trash in it at all. Oh, it's kind of comfortable, better than a chair.
That's our show, everyone.
I came to tell you this year is your last.
What?
They can't replace you if everyone loves you.
Do none of you understand what is at stake here? I am being replaced. Think about why the show is bad and come up with ways to fix it.
I wish I was a woman of color so I could just get any job I want.
We talked about this, you can't say that.
I know what everyone thinks of me, but just because I was lucky enough to get this job doesn't mean I'm stupid enough to lose it.
What exactly is wrong with my bits?
You're a little old and a little white.
What can I do about that?
I have some jokes for the monologue. I shouldn't do this in an English accent, should I?
No.
Watch me!
This is your show. It's an expression of who you are.
How would you describe Molly?
She said I was the vibrant splash of color on the gray canvas of our writing staff. I mean, whoosh.
I need you, Molly. I need your pushiness and lack of boundaries.
You love me.
No, I didn't say that.
I mean, not in those words, but you...
No, I didn't say it in any of those words.
Watch me!